people seen in the news tonight in Entebbe. Fishermen at Chigungu landing site have been given 5 days to register all their boats before opening of fishing business on the site. Now, the ultimatum has been issued by State Minister in charge of fisheries, Helen Adoa, who this afternoon visited the site to ascertain affairs since business was halted following the killing of a UPDF officer of the Fisheries Protection Unit.
For 2 weeks, business at Chigungu landing site has been at a standstill after two fishermen allegedly killed a UPDF officer attached to the Fisheries Protection Unit while on duty. The move was intended to foster proper investigations into the matter. However, after the culprits were apprehended, the landing site remains closed, leaving it to the dismay of fishermen. Today, the state minister in charge of fisheries, Helen Andoa, visited the site.
Training one fisheries protection unit soldier is not an easy thing. So losing one fisheries protection unit soldier gives us a setback, because there are very few soldiers in the lake and training them is very difficult. We need soldiers in the lake for two reasons. They need to protect you as a fisherman. In Lake Alubat right now, our fishermen have been killed by some wrong elements from Congo. And we are working around the clock to share with my colleague on the other side to stop this kind of things.
Was murdered by fishermen in the course of restoring. So the fishermen who had committed suicide by throwing themselves into water. So the soldier, using his skills, he went into water to save the soldiers, rather the fishermen. Unfortunately, after saving them, the people drove off the boat, kidnapped him, took him, and killed him, and threw the body in the lake.
The locals have urged government to allow them work because they don't have any other source of income.
They have promised us that they are going to compare the risks. They are going to generate that list and then they compare it with the list they have at the ministry. But currently, the situation is still terrible, and I have talked to the state minister. At least as they register, they should also prepare for some COVID relief support.
The minister then asked the fishermen to register as she addresses the matter with the president.
My fishermen, I don't have a single record of this landing site. This landing site is not gazetted. Most of you registered under some landing sites. I want you to use those forms for registration that you are starting today. By Friday, the majority of you will be in the lake. I don't want you to worry. As long as you have been a registered fisherman or fisherwoman, just get those forms and say, this is my registration, I registered under such and such a site, and they copy.
Andoa insists that all fishermen have to follow the guidelines of the Fisheries Protection Unit, as this is aimed at curbing illegal fishing.
We need to utilize and use our lakes well for tomorrow. Your grandchildren, my grandchildren, will need the lake. If my great-grandparents had misused the lake, I would have not got a fish.
Story by Godfrey Sempija for the news.